Mike, the longest-serving active Calgary Stampeder is retiring. Jeff Pilon's decade of destruction has come to an end. He has stopped by BT to tackle the subject. Good morning, Jeff.
Good morning. Thank you for having me.
Big question on everybody's minds. I mean, coming off a half-decent year, why now? Why was the time right to retire?
I had a job opportunity with Jamie Crisdale and Gridiron, and it was an opportunity that you just can't pass up. And CFL, the sad thing about it, we don't make as much money as the NFL, and I've been playing 10 years, but I can't retire on the money I make in the CFL. So this is for life after football, and to set up my family and to just to start a whole new career.
I was saying you're 34, so very young, you know, when we're using 34 and retiring in the same sentence. But physically, football has taken a toll on you.
I've had a few operations here and there. Mm-hmm. I've had 7 operations over the years, knees, shoulders, and elbows. I've taken a few bangs and bruises, but, you know, it's part of the game. And it's actually, I'm just watching the highlight here with Jamie on there as well. And a little scuffled. Yeah. Good times.
You remember that.
Oh, yeah. You know, it's stuff like that that you remember, you know, and your body does take a beating, but it's part of the game, and, you know, I'm not going to go around telling everybody, hey, I hurt myself today, but, you know, it happens.
More or less three different routes. You can either be, you know, eliminated from a team, mm-hmm. and another team doesn't pick you up. Mm-hmm. You can have an injury that will not allow you to play, or you can do what the Jeff Pilons of the world do and say, my time is now. I'm ready to walk away from the game. How good does it feel to know that this is your choice?
That's a loaded question, because, I mean, it feels great that it is my choice, but I'm leaving my teammates. I'm leaving something that I've done for so long. Teammates are just awesome, great guys. I mean, a great city. And to not to be a part of that is going to be really hard.
Mm-hmm. You were saying to me that you might not be able to watch the games for a bit.
Explain that, because you're a football guy.
Yeah, because I can associate myself with those guys. I mean, most of those guys are still going to be back. Mm-hmm. So, and knowing that I can still play, I can still go out there and do it, it's kind of rough. So once those guys kind of disperse and leave, then I'll probably be able to watch and say, okay, you know, I'm now aged a little bit more and might not be able to quite do it. But yeah, so it's definitely going to be rough for next little bit.
Let's talk about the highlights. I mean, there were more than a few highlights from Grey Cups to, whatever championship you may have achieved, mm-hmm. even before maybe the CFL. But in your mind, I mean, because we can look at the stat sheets, what were the highlights?
Some guys can tell you minute by minute, step by step, what they did, all that kind of stuff. I can have moments, who I blocked, how I blocked them. As you saw, some pretty intense moments against Edmonton, which was great. My moments were the best I've ever had with my kids.
Really?
Having them walk across the field with me was absolutely the best highlight ever. And that was my goal for the time I played. I said 10 years was my goal, and to have memories for my daughter and for my son.
That's huge.
That was the best memory. But, you know, seeing those highlights and just being able to be out there with the guys, I can walk the field, and I can tell you. I mean, any field in this league, I can walk, and I can tell you who I was blocking and what happened. I couldn't tell you the score, I couldn't tell you the down and distance, but I can tell you what was going on. So
you got the hardware on when we talk about highlights. Grey Cup champion right here. And do the kids ever get to try those on?
Oh yeah. One's gonna be don't know who's gonna get which one, but they're gonna be able to pick which one they get. And
I thought you said I could have one.
Sure,
I can't
believe
you're reneging on this stuff.
There you go.
Every time I get a chance to wear one of these things here. Now let's talk about a life after football, and mm-hmm. everybody knows the name Jamie Crisdale. What is Gridiron? What are you going to be doing?
We're going to be doing blasting up in the oil sands, up in St. Crude, blasting and helping them try to extract some of the oil out of the sands.
It makes sense that Jeff Pilon would be doing blasting in Fort McMurray. It just seems to fit for some reason.
Definitely. It is awesome. I mean, just the size of the vehicles, the size of the equipment, some of these blasts that go off. Jamie said when he come up here, he said you'll be addicted to it. It's just like a kid. You get to go blow things up. So it's really cool, really fun time. So,
Andy's lamenting because you were a participant in Buffet Week.
One of the key
back in the day, and he was hoping that you'd have one more tour in you.
When it comes to buffets and food, I'm in.
You'll
for sure.
And a side note, I remember one buffet, Jamie told us he had two bowls of cereal before he got to the buffet.
Yes.
He destroyed the buffet, and then we watched him drive into an A&W parking lot on the way out.
Have breakfast.
Food.
I was trying to gain weight.
He was trying to. He's the only one.
Jeff Pilon, a great Calgarian, a great Calgary Stampeder, and congratulations on an amazing career.
And look for a slim down Jeff Pilon, minus the buffet tour, because he says he has to drop a few pounds.
A few more pounds, yeah.
Jeff Pilon.
Thanks for being here, Jeff.
Thank you very much. I really appreciate it, guys.
We're going to take a break here on BT. An iPad, we're giving one away this week, and we're letting you know today's clue. It's an iPad app.